So with iTunes version 12.7, a lot of functionality has been removed that helps you sync things from your Mac to your iPhone, like apps. And one of the things that seems to be removed is the ability to sync custom ringtones. But it's actually still there, and it's simpler than ever. So let me show you how you can now get a custom ringtone to your iPhone. First, let's start by getting a custom ringtone. So MacMost has always had this set of custom ringtones that's legal for you to download and use as you want. It's at macmost.com/free-iphone-ringtones. And you can browse the different collections here. Let's go and take a look at one of the sets, Classic Rings. And you can see there's a preview here as an MP3, or you can download the M4R. And M4R files are really MP3 files. You can just change the file extension. But they're the extension for custom ringtones for the iPhone. So let's go and download this bell ring here, and we'll put it in the downloads folder. So in the downloads folder, I've got that one file. Let's move that out just to the desktop over here, just temporarily. So let's switch to iTunes. And I've already got my iPhone plugged into my Mac. So you'll see it appear here as this little icon at the top left. So I just click on that to go to the screen that shows me information about my iPhone. Now we'll start here in summary. But what I want to do is I want to switch to looking at the ringtones on my device. So there'll first be settings here. And this is where you would have seen perhaps ringtones before. But we don't have that anymore. But still on my device we still have tones. I click on that and it shows the ringtones that are on my iPhone. So what's really changed here is the ability for iTunes to store ringtones. That's just not done anymore. But you can still look at the ringtones that are installed on the device. And here I've got one custom one. So let's add another one. Now here's where it really gets simple. All you need to do is drag and drop. So I drag and drop into there and it updates. You don't even have to hit sync or anything. It just automatically adds that bell ring ringtone to my iPhone. So looking at my settings app now, if I go to sounds and I select something like ringtone, you can see at the top there I have the two custom ringtones before all the defaults. And those will also be available in other places. Like for instance, if I set text tone, it won't be there at the top, but it will be there under ringtones. So I can use these throughout for my alerts. Now let's say you want to delete the ringtone from your iPhone. So you would do that here in iTunes as well. And when you're in the tones section here, you would control click and you get delete from library. And that allows you to remove it. Now if you don't see delete from library, that's probably because under summary here you don't have manually managed turned on. Manually managed, no matter what it says, and in my case it just says videos because I'm using Apple Music, but for you it might say music, videos, etc. If you don't have that on, then you, for whatever reason, you can add ringtones but you can't delete them.